Can I delete pagefile.sys? Hey everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Pagefile.sys, along with swapfile.sys, are files created by Windows to manage memory usage. It takes special steps to remove it. It's not difficult. I've got instructions. The catch, of course, is that you probably don't want to. And even if you do, it won't make much of a difference unless you're really low on RAM. Pagefile.sys is the Windows paging file, also known as the swap or virtual memory file. Virtual memory is disk space that's used by Windows when it runs out of physical memory, in other words, RAM. When a program on the computer uses a lot of RAM, perhaps trying to use more RAM than the machine actually has, some existing RAM contents are written to the paging file. If the paged out memory, as it's referred to, is needed again, other RAM is written to disk, again to the paging file, and then the previously written information is read back in. It's where Windows juggles and keeps track of the demands for a lot of memory. Note that pagefile.sys is a system file. To see the file in Windows File Explorer, the option to show hidden files and folders must be enabled, and hide protected operating system files must be disabled. Since the file is being used by Windows even when it's not actively paging memory, you can't just delete it. It'll either tell you permission denied, file in use, or something like that. Extra steps are required. Now, you may notice that pagefile.sys is roughly the same size as your virtual memory settings. That's the clue. This leads to our first way to get rid of it. Set your virtual memory to zero and reboot. Once you return, Windows will no longer be using the file and will let you delete it. You might need to use an administrative command prompt to delete it. If you actually have enough RAM in your system to handle the amount of memory needed to run all the programs you use at the same time, you might not need virtual memory at all. I, for example, have lots of RAM and often run with no virtual memory configured and no pagefile.sys present on my drive. Note, however, pagefile.sys will return if you re-enable virtual memory. Now, the other approach to deleting pagefile.sys is less useful, but I'll talk about it anyway. Boot into another operating system and delete the file. So, for example, if you boot from a Linux Live USB or DVD and explore your Windows hard drive, you'll find and you should actually be able to delete pagefile.sys. However, as soon as you boot back into Windows, as long as you have virtual memory enabled, pagefile.sys will return. My recommendation, let Windows manage the file. Unless you have a reason to adjust your virtual memory settings or know that you could run without virtual memory at all, I suggest leaving the settings and pagefile.sys the way they are. Given today's large hard disks, the amount of space taken by pagefile.sys is generally small in comparison anyway. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/15171. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.